All right, welcome back to part three of my long, lengthy list of videos of my collection. We're working on this shelf section here, which is, we're on to the D's through H. And in my last video, the ever-present and knowledgeable Andrew noticed, quite rightly, that I didn't cover Dawn of the Dead or Day of the Dead. So let me briefly explain the method of the madness here. If I've filed the film and shelved it, I've watched the whole Blu-ray. You know, if I've watched the film, so I have a section where I've watched the movie, but maybe I haven't watched all the commentaries and special features. And so I have a what I call an in-process stack. And that what happened was in the October Horror Challenge, I watched those two films, but I didn't make my way through all the special features. So it's in a different stack, essentially. I've got a stack in-process. I've got a stack unwatched stack, which is going to be probably three videos. I think everybody's probably got an embarrassingly large stack of films that they bought that they haven't watched yet. Mine's pretty significant as well. In fact, you might see above here on the shelving, those films up there that line the shelf are non-horror that I haven't watched yet. So, but we're going to get to those. You know, it's coming. All right, so I'm working on D, films that I've watched and now filed away, just to cover those gaps that Andrew was so careful to point out. Let me cover a couple things that were kind of in process that were not in this listing alphabetically. One is Dark Knight of the Scarecrow. And this is a made-for-TV film that this is out of print now. I don't know if it's out of print now, but it definitely has had moments where it's been outrageously expensive to purchase. So you might want to look out for Dark Knight of the Scarecrow. It's excellent, excellent TV horror movie from the 70s. Day of the Dead. I've got two copies. I've got the old Anchor Bay THX release. And then, of course, I recently purchased the Collector's Edition Blu-ray from Scream Factory. Shout Factory, Scream Factory, what have you. So, yeah, I do have those. I also have, and I believe this is out of print, this old Ultimate Edition of Dawn of the Dead. And this has, of course, all three films. The international cut, the theatrical cut. Yeah, it's a really nice set. So I've seen Dawn of the Dead, I don't know, 10, 20 times. But I haven't really ever worked my way through this whole package. So that's kind of why it's not in the alphabetical filed stack. It's in my process list. So let me put that back. I'll be right back. Okay, so these are D through E. D through I, I'm sorry, that I've watched and filed away. Like I say, if there's gaps and things that you think, well, why doesn't he have that? I probably do have it. It's just either it's in my processed watch pile or unwatched pile. So, okay. First up is Howling. I've got the 10 of Howling the Trilogy here. This is an old DVD 10. These are horrible, horrible. Most of these are just crap movies, in my opinion. I've got Howling 2, Scream Factory release, which was excellent. I've got the original Howling, of course. I hope everybody has that. I also have Hills Have Eyes remake, unrated remake, and this is probably, in my opinion, one of the best remakes ever. And I mean, it's kind of unfair to compare it to the original Wes Craven film, but comparisons are inevitable. But I think this is a better movie. Sorry, Wes, but Hills Have Eyes 2, unrated. I love this one, too. Sorry, I mean, these are one of the few exceptions where I think the modern-day remake I prefer to the original. I got the original Hills Have Eyes on Blu-ray. I also have the Anchor Bay. It's in the unwatched pile. We'll get to that one. Hills Have Eyes 2. Let's see. I've got the Exorcist box. This is DVD. I really need to upgrade this. It's a workable box set of all the Exorcist films. I mean, it's okay. Quality of picture wise, I could probably do better with some of the newer releases. Dan Curtis's Dracula in Jekyll and Hyde. This is Jack Palance, and I thought he was great in with Dracula. Excellent, excellent, underrated Dracula film. Hatchet. Adam Green film. Probably still his best, in my opinion. I got an old midnight release of Dunwich Horror, H.P. Lovecraft. Good film. Excellent film from the 60s. Hatchet 2. I like that one too. Hatchet 3. I don't like Hatchet 3 as much. I don't dislike it. I just don't like it as much as the first two. And then one of my favorites, one I grew up with. I love Darren McGavin. Is Night Stalker. Night Stalker and Night Strangler. Night Stalker scared me as a kid. I mean, it's so, you know, it's one of the few Dracula films, or vampire, I should say vampire films. It's one of the few vampire films that, at least when I was growing up, had a realism to it. And I think it was just mainly because of Dan Curtis's documentary style. He was kind of the way he filmed his movies was a precursor, in my opinion, to a lot of the found footage that you see today. But it's disturbing because it seems so at the moment and so real, you know. Okay. Moving on. Let's get these out of the shelf here. Up first, Doctor and the Devils. This is out on Blu-ray. I have not upgraded yet, but it's a great film. Don't Open Till Christmas. I did a full review of that during the 31 days of Christmas horror. Don't Go in the Woods. I mean, this is a epic slasher comedy, just so bad it's good, cheese fest. Dead End. Dead End is an extremely underrated horror film. I'm not sure I like the supernatural elements at the end, but I thought it was an excellent movie. It never had a theatrical release. It ended up being straight to video, which is a shame. Now, I've got the Blu-ray of Dan Curtis' Dracula. That's probably why I've got that up there as the DVD, because I've got the Blu-ray. I really highly recommend, if you've not seen Jack Palance's portrayal of Dracula, you need to check it out. Dog Soldiers. Deathgasm. Kind of a metal, heavy metal horror movie. This is a DVD rip of Dracula. This was the British BBC back in the 50s Dracula film. Not bad. I'm trying to remember. Uh, 1968, yeah. 1968, basically a British take on it, BBC take on it. Dead of Winter from the Slasher Classics Collection with Mary Steenburgen. Deliver Us from Evil. I like this movie. Very disturbing. Got Dread, which was an interesting and disturbing film as well. I thought this was very, very good. It's a Clive Barker film. Old DVD of Driller Killer. I've got the Blu-ray, the steelbook that came out on this. Drive-In Massacre, Slasher Classics Collection. Murders in the Rue Morgue and the Blu-ray of Dunwich Horror. This is the Scream Factory double feature. Most of you probably have that. Two-disc special edition of Eaten Alive. An underrated Tobe Hooper film. The Entity. I believe this is Barbara Bach. I'm trying to... No, Barbara Hershey. I'm sorry. Yeah, Barbara Hershey. Barbara Hershey was excellent in this. The Editor, excellent giallo film, highly recommended. Evil Laugh, a low budget slasher film. Father's Day, Trauma. Fatal Frames. A lot of people like this slasher film. This one didn't sit well with me. I thought it was long and tedious. Fear X. This is a great film. I love this film. I believe this is a Nicholas Winding Refn film. And and it's an excellent film. I loved it. Fear X. I've got a four-pack of Final Destination films. If you've seen one, you've seen them all. Final Destination 5 was good. Final Draft, Clown Killer. Final Exam, one of the 80s classic slasher films with the nameless killer. No motive. The ending was, it does have quite a bit of slow moments to it, but it's still a classic. Final Terror, one of my favorite 80s slasher films. I love Final Terror. If you don't have Final Terror, I would recommend this one. Great special features. The director, Andrew Davis, is interviewed in this. Basically, it's a take on Friday the 13th. It's one of the early, kids going camping type deals. The Fly remake. Excellent. And finally, a Euro Blu-ray of Fright Night. So that's going to make up that row. Okay, now we're getting into the F's, remaining F's and G's. By the way, obviously Dracula and Frankenstein, Universal stuff is a whole different section. Here's a BBC release of Frankenstein. It's a DVD-R. This one, I'm trying to remember. Well, the big thing about this one was it was an early role of Ian Holm, Alien, plays the robot in Alien. Ian Holm played the monster in that. Donald Sutherland, Frankenstein, 2.5 hours, but very good. And an underrated interpretation of Frankenstein is the Mary Shelley made-for-TV Frankenstein. This is this one comes at it much closer to the book, but it also the monster is normal from the onset. It's kind of like Revenge of Frankenstein. You've got a normal monster that, through a series of events, ends up getting evil and disfigured, but he doesn't start out ugly. He starts out very nice, very, very pretty, for lack of a better term. Jane Seymour, it's got Jane Seymour and James Mason. Excellent cast. Frankenhooker, I love this. Frank Henlotter, great film. Arrow release. Frailty, highly recommended. One of my favorite Matthew McConaughey films. This is an awesome film. Love that one. Frayed. A serviceable horror movie. Of course, the Blu-ray of The Fog. Scream Factory. Funhouse Massacre. I got this at Walmart for $8. Frightmare. Excellent film. Highly recommend this, Frightmare. The Funhouse. What happened to the slipcover on that? I used to have a slipcover for that. This is a movie I grew up with as a kid. It's another one that kind of scared the crap out of me. Now it's just kind of a camp classic, and that is Gargoyles. Cornel Wilde plays... that too, Gargoyles, man, they look great in this. 1970s. Ginger Snaps. Ghost Ship. I got this. This is... I think the Euro release. Well, this is the remake. Yeah, this is the remake. Yeah. This is the remake with the lenticular cover. Jack Ketchum's The Girl Next Door. I tell you what, Jack Ketchum's stuff is excellent material. And this is a good film. Graduation Day. I also have the Slasher Classics release of that. Oops. Light's pretty bad there. Graduation Day. God Told Me to Kill. Another highly, highly recommended film. Excellent. Grace. You can tell from the baby bottle there that we've got some bizarre images with a baby, and God Told Me To. What a great movie. This is a must have. God Told Me To. You got to have this in your collection. I can't say enough good things about this one. Larry Cohen is a great independent director, and this is one of his best. The Guest. I like this film. I didn't love it. I liked it. Of course, The Green Room. Who doesn't have The Green Room? One of the great modern horror films last few years. Hallowed Ground. It's a sci-fi channel scarecrow movie. Is Harpoon, Whale Watcher Massacre. I got this because, of course, you got Gunnar Hansen in it. It's fun. Silly. It's silly, but fun. I got another copy of Harvest of Fear, along with that double. I got a double feature in this one, too. Not sure why I double dipped on that one. Headless, which is signed by the director. I ordered this directly from the website. Brutal, gory film, but excellent. Excellent retro 80s type slasher film. Headless. kind of a, if you've seen the movie Found, this was a prequel to Found. I've got the Haunted Anthology, which has Blair Witch on it. Others, The Last Exorcism, Insidious. Henry, Portrait of a Serial Killer. I would say these character studies of serial killers, you know, if you push me to the wall and made me rank them real quick, I'd have to go with I Saw the Devil, is, and then Angst would be the number one serial killer portrayal, followed by I Saw the Devil, and then Henry. Henry Portrait of a Silk Killer. Excellent, excellent. All right. Last row for the day here. Well into the H's. All right. Let's see what we got here. Hole in the Wall. Indie horror film. Pretty disturbing stuff. But I can recommend it. And it's signed by the producer, director. Hollywood Chainsaw Hookers. Slasher Classics Collection. Fun movie. Henry 2 for the sequel. Excellent. I like this one just as good as the first. Hitchhike, which I think has a Blu-ray release now, but I got this before that came out. I like this a whole lot. I don't know that it warrants a double dip. This actually has an interview with the stars Franco Nero and David Hess, who were excellent in this. Hell. It's all right. Hell High. I would say this is a top 10 slasher film from the 80s. Excellent. And the Joe Bob Briggs commentary is just off the chart. Great. This is a must own. Hell High. Highly recommend this if you don't have it. Hazmat. It's okay. It's okay slasher film. Bruno Mattei's Hell of the Living Dead. This is the DVD. I think there's a Blu-ray release of this now. Special feature-wise, on this Anchor Bay, this is an old Anchor Bay. Not a whole lot, but this is a batshit crazy movie, as is most of Bruno Mattei's films, batshit crazy. Hidden in the Woods. South American film, horror film, and it is... It's a rough ride, very rough ride. A lot of disturbing type stuff in that. High attention. I'm not a big fan of this. I thought it was predictable, and I also thought that it shamelessly copied Texas Chainsaw Massacre. And I don't like the ending at all. So I'm just not a fan. I know people are big on High Tension, but I don't like that film too much. House 1 and 2. I've got the Arrow box set on order. House of Seven Corpses. This is a made-for-TV film with John Carradine. A little slow, but I'll tell you, the last 20 minutes is a pretty excellent gothic horror movie. Hills Run Red. I like this one a lot. Excellent slasher film. Excellent modern day slasher film. Horror Hotel. Another excellent British horror movie. Hostel 1 and 2. I like both. Got no problems with Hostel. I don't really consider it torture porn. I don't really like that. I don't really like that term anyway. One of my favorite Udo Kier films is House on Straw Hill. Highly recommend this release. This is a 7 release. Housebound. Very good modern day horror film. Happy Birthday to Me. I just got the Blu-ray release, which is in my unwatched pile. House on Sorority Row. Finally got my hands on this Blu-ray. One of the top classic slasher films of all time, of course. House on Sorority Row. The Horror Show. House of Dark Shadows, Blu-ray. Another Dan Curtis made-for-TV film, Barnabas Collins, as a take on the Dark Shadows TV show. Love this film, grew up with it, excellent. Devil's Rejects and House of a Thousand Corpses. I enjoy both these films very much. I still would argue that these two films are really Rob Zombie's best. Madman, another horror film that I think is kind of a must-own in your collection. This is an excellent, excellent horror film. And an interesting take on, it's witty and sophisticated. I think it's an excellent, excellent film. It's got a audio commentary with the director, Tibor Takacs. It's a Scream Factory release. Probably all you guys already got this. I said it before, I'll say it again. I Saw the Devil. Only angst tops this in terms of a character study of a serial killer. This is a great, great Asian horror film. Excellent stuff. I Know What You Did Last Summer. I like this. Okay, it's a teen film. I get that, but I thought it was well done and enjoyable. Lots of tension. So that is gonna do it for that shelf, and that gets us through, or gets us partially through, all the way to the eyes. I need to cover this section here, which has got Halloween and Friday the 13th and some of my other stuff on. This is kind of a box set. I put my box sets on top, so I will cover that in the next video and then move on to I through whatever, KJ. It's going to keep going. There's going to be a lot of these videos. Quite an undertaking, actually, now that I've started it. But I hope you enjoy it, and I will be back. Thanks for watching.